Visiting schools throughout the country for his recent report, Sir Peter Williams observed much existing good practice in mathematics. However, his review does identify some key areas where maths learning could be significantly improved. One school that particularly impressed Sir Peter is the inappropriately named Weeke Primary in Winchester. So, what are they doing at Weeke to strengthen their maths teaching? What are they doing to make maths real?
I think here, where we're most successful, we do get the child right at the heart of the learning, and children can see that the teacher knows them well. They've taken the time and the trouble to A, find out what their interests are, but then to put that into planning. And that takes time and effort, and children appreciate that. They realise that their own interests are being used to help with their learning. So that relationship between the children and the teacher is what makes a success.
OK, so hands ready. So we go down.
What I always try and do is start off the lesson with a warm-up exercise, some sort of breathing, some sort of active standing up, clapping, anything really, to just get the children on the ball. Then we tend to do a song, anything that has sort of counting in it, really, that the children can get up and enjoy singing. And then before I actually start the main input of whatever the lesson is going to be, I will do some sort of number work.
Can you show me two? Show me seven. Seven. Good girl.
The most important thing is that the children have fun. They look forward to coming to their lessons. They're energetic and they are learning through their actions.
And
ten!
Well done, well done. How many spots on this side? Can you show me? How many spots on this side of Bill the ladybird? Show me. What do we do, Sam?
I don't want them to get to Key Stage 2 and say that they hate maths. I want them to get to Key Stage 2 and really love it and understand it.
How many? Show me. There's 10. So should we show how we do that as a number bond? We say 0
and 10 equals 10.
I devised these symbols at the beginning of the year alongside the children. To make it the maths more personal to them so that they have ownership of their mathematical learning. And I think it's really worked quite well.
What is an equal sign? Equals, Sam.
I didn't know when I devised them how well it would go down, if they would actually remember it or not, but they have, and they've really taken it on board. And now, when we're doing any addition, they use those symbols as well, and it really enforces the point.
And 9 equals... Brilliant.
They actually get to get up and use their bodies, and they're always having to think ahead, which is key in maths. They're not just, it's not that they've learnt it by rote, because they have to remember those symbols and where they're going to put them.
Zoe, how many spots on this side?
2.
Who can tell me?
What Sir Peter particularly liked was the culture. He liked the fact that fun and enjoyment and confidence underpinned what we do in maths. The teachers have to be relaxed and confident, and they have to have fun teaching the subject.
Just going to wait for everyone to have the right sausages up.
3 and 7 equals 10!
There are more smiles across the corridor where Jane is teaching a mixed year 3 and 4 class.
Numbers in the column.
Numbers in the column.
Two lines. Two lines.
Two lines. Two lines.
Out.
Out.
At the right.
At the right.
At the left.
At the left.
Boing tens over.
Boing tens over.
Boing hundreds over.
Boing hundreds over.
Put it under.
Put it under.
I want the children to learn without knowing that they're actually learning. So I think if you make the lesson really fun and enjoyable, they forget that they're learning and they just do it without thinking.
George! Now, using our wrap, what's the next thing we've got to do?
Shh. Two lines! Two lines!
Two lines! Two lines! Let's put two lines in.
The success criteria we developed together as a class. We looked at column addition and then we wrote lists on a step-by-step guide on how to achieve that.
Add the right, then add the left. That's to tell you, like, first of all, you add the units, which is like...
Once we'd done that, we've simplified it, and then the children created their own actions and their own rap to go with it.
Boing tens over, because you have to put the ten.
And if they've got a little routine or a little rap, then it can help them work out what the next step is and just sort of make it a bit easier for them to get through their work rather than panic, I think.